Live from Bompton, Compton, California. Put your hands together for the Boss Mac Top Song.
What's the deal, man?
Hey, yo, man, I'm happy you could come in here and fuck with us tonight, man.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful situation, man, you know. Let me get into this. You know how we get down. We always start off with our sponsors. And then, you know, niggas in the news read the listener emails and whatnot, and we're gonna have our interview with Pookie F'n Rude in this motherfucker. But let me start off real quick with our sponsor. We got a new sponsor. Simple Truth Organic. Simple Truth Organic Kombucha. Nigga, be healthy out there, man. You gotta be a healthy motherfucker, man. I'ma tell you, that shit tastes like some fruit beer in this motherfucker. You know, it's supposed to be healthy, but it tastes like some fruit beer in this motherfucker. But it's alright though. It's alright though, man. I ain't gonna hate on it. Yeah, man. Wait, hold on.
You go to the supermarket, you see it in there in certain places, man, or you look online and fuck with it, man. Kombucha is kind of coming up. A lot of, you know, white people be fucking with kombucha, man. Niggas don't be fucking with kombucha. That's why I'm pitching it to niggas. You feel me? Our second sponsor is Trojan Ultra Thin Bare Skin Condoms, man. Y'all little motherfuckers already know, man. I'm an advocate of y'all motherfuckers going way too raw on every bitch you saw. Y'all niggas need to fall back and be more practical in your application, you feel me? Some of y'all niggas, man, it's ridiculous out here, man. Trojan Ultra Thin Bare Skin Condoms, nigga. You hear me?
Get them bare skins.
Now, you know, I know raw is bomb. I know I like doing it too. But man, you know, just you know,
Them diseases is real, my nigga. They real. You feel me? Damn, my shit. My mic, son. Right. Alright. Now, our last sponsor. Now, I don't got the pack with me, man, but I'm faulty with my advertising, man, but wait a minute, hold on. Let me do it right. I don't want to fuck it off, man. Hold on. Alright. Now, our final sponsor, I ain't gonna even lie, man, I'm gonna have to switch it up on y'all motherfuckers, is G Machine in downtown Long Beach, 255 East 4th Street. You know, they've been fucking with BOSSMACK for years, man. So you can go in there, get some BOSSMACK streetwear, fuck with Sam, holla at Sam. He like the world's greatest hustler, man. You already know. The world's greatest hustler, you know. You go in there and watch Sam get down for 5 minutes, man. You be like, goddamn, man. I can't believe it, man. You see why you're a motherfucking millionaire, I'm telling you. Alright, that's about it. We gonna go into our motherfucking, niggas in the motherfucking nose. Niggas in the motherfucking nose. Pookie fucking Rude in the building with the BOSSMACK tops off. How you doing tonight, my brother?
I'm doing pretty good, man. I'm doing pretty good. Blessed, man.
Feeling good.
Feeling good, feeling great.
Man, I'm glad you come here and fuck with me tonight, man.
You invited me. I'm coming.
That's what I'm talking about. See, that's a real motherfucker right there, man. You got to salute the process. I'm on the fruit beer and shit. Don't get you drunk. All right, now. Niggas in the motherfucking news. Niggas in the motherfucking news. And Pookie fucking Rude, the first nigga in the news, is Cardi B. Okay, bro.
Yeah.
He's a real ass LA nigga. I mean, you a
Long Beach. I'm a Long Beach. Yeah, Long Beach. Long Beach.
Respect to LA niggas, but you a real Long Beach nigga.
Yeah.
But you know what's popping.
Right.
He's aware of what Cardi B said or posted.
Which one is it? The one when she says she got the flu on?
Yeah.
Showing her where that flu?
Yeah. It's something else? Is that another one?
Is that what you're talking about?
That's the one I'm talking
about. Okay, yeah, I seen that. Somebody asked me about that today.
Okay.
Honestly speaking, I laugh at it.
It was funny to me, too.
It's funny. It's like, I can't take any disrespect from somebody who's not from the soil area of what's going on. Like, you're a gimmick to me. Like, obviously, apparently somebody is feeding you what to say.
Right.
You dig what I'm talking about?
Right.
Like, the whole thing with the Barty B. You feel what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
You came out your name Cardi. You was oblivious to anything with B's or C's. But once you stepped into a different realm, you know what I'm saying, you got to introduce this shit, so now you figure out, oh, I want to do this, I want to do that. It's funny to me, like,
right.
You don't even understand what you're doing.
Right.
So as soon as you try to come out to L.A. or anything of that matter, and you wonder why some of the homegirls from somewhere else or something else is bopping you aside the head, understand, that's why. So you got yourself into, like, you know, I think people just need to do their research and understand. A lot of shit that they saying that they think is for fad or for fun really ain't that.
It's real ass shit. Yeah,
you get your shit fucked over, like.
Yeah.
You know, so, but she's from Brooklyn. She's from New York.
Right.
I can't take anything she say about California serious at all.
But she wasn't even really saying it about California.
She wasn't. She was just saying
in general.
Flu, but she don't understand how many ear she sparked when she said that. Like, first of all, we ignored the fact that you changed Cardi B to Barty B. And then when you was on the interview and we got asked about it, you tried to lie about it and say, what's the reason and why you have it Barty B? Like, let's get real.
But you know them niggas in New York, they on the gang shit, though.
I mean, they on it, but like how 6ix9ine tried to say he on the gang shit, too. A couple of homies I know, they out there fucking with 6ix9ine New York, but a couple of other people I know, they don't like how he's coming out.
Right.
You feel what I'm talking about?
Right.
The whole rainbow rapper and all that type shit. And
yeah.
Allegedly, they got a video of him getting done in the butt. I seen a photo on Jablo page.
That's like a real thing. Like, you shit. That's like a real.
Yeah, done in the butt.
That's like for real. Like,
shit, I don't know. I wouldn't know.
This is what I think about, like, a nigga like, when I see 6ix9ine and shit, I feel like it's some niggas behind him that we can't see. That's like some real niggas that's put this together. That's like,
yeah, probably
this is
so.
Gonna make some money right here, and we're gonna back this little nigga up. So,
yeah.
We're gonna put him out there with rainbow hair and
but
shit.
If you were some real niggas, I wouldn't be behind that at all. You gotta think about it, you feel me? Ain't no real niggas. Go sit there and be like, yeah, let's push this nigga as 6ix9ine the artist. He's a Skittle rapper. He's gay. But he's gonna be tough gay. Like, I don't get unless you got some hood bangers or some hood gay bangers right now. Some gangsta ass gay niggas that every time they go to Pride, they punking the fuck out of all the gay people type shit. He got the gangsta gay people behind him or something. I don't know.
Okay,
I have no filter, I'm sorry.
Hey, man, you spit how you want to spit it, man. You know, that's, you talk freely on this motherfucker, man.
For sure.
Let me tell you, man, now, I'm glad you hold those opinions, because look. All right. Imagine you, a nigga sitting in your hood, and you got a whole bunch of niggas around you that's rap, say they rap, you know what I'm saying? Everybody
right.
Sound the same and shit.
Right.
And then you got this motherfucker right here. He's different. You feel me?
Very different.
Bitches like him. He's popping without, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
He wants to be around. We're protecting him. What if we put him out and he blown, you know what I'm saying? And we just, that's the type of shit. I mean, now you can say like,
Are you good? Come on. You about to walk in.
You good?
Yeah, my brother's about to walk in. He's killing me.
Okay. Right now, I mean, when you thinking about the bag, you feel me? Like, if you thinking about how you may look to motherfuckers, but if you thinking about the bag, I mean, he making millions of dollars.
Bro. Nah. My self-dignity is everything before a fucking bag.
Now, I'm not saying that I would do it, you feel me?
Right.
But I'm saying that it's niggas who do, you know what I mean?
That's them niggas you won't ever see me fucking with. I'm Bill 100. Like, if you could sell yourself short for money,
yeah,
I don't understand what's your place of living. That makes sense. Like, can't no amount make me sell myself short.
I feel you.
You feel me? I will be happy exactly how I am now.
Okay, I feel you, my nigga.
To be 100% me. And to be who I am, and to like what I like, and my interest in what it's in.
Okay.
I don't have to change for anyone.
For real.
You know what I mean? And I would rather live how I am, and be who I am.
Right.
Than to sit there and get a bag, and have to be someone else or do shit way out my character. You dig what I'm talking about?
I'm right there with you, my nigga.
And that's only coming from the heart, like. I know a lot of niggas who sold themselves short, or who done a lot of fuck shit because of the money amount.
For that camera right there.
The money amount or the bag that they want. So what they do, a lot of false shit. I can't do that. Like,
I feel you.
I can't get in this game and get Don Cornelius.
Okay, now let's take it back to old girl now. Did you notice the
the fallout. Like, it's Crips in motherfucking New York, yeah. Right? Yeah. It wasn't even offended like that. It was motherfuckers from out here. It's
the simple fact, like, Cardi B, you're from New York. Why are you even saying flu? What's your whole reason of saying flu? It didn't bother me. I could care less. I don't give a fuck. Let her say what she want to say. Shit.
Right,
the
right,
fuck?
Right.
Her teeth ain't real. So what? Right. You feel what I'm talking about?
Right.
So it's like, she can say what the fuck she want to say.
Right.
She ain't come at nobody disrespectful. Like, she didn't say, oh, you ass niggas, look at this flu I got on. Fuck all. Like, she didn't come at it like that. Like,
right,
but
right.
In a sense, it's like some people don't let shit slide. You feel me? Some people really want to catch everything.
Yeah.
That's too much time and energy up on something that's pointless. I don't give a fuck.
I feel you, my
nigga. You feel me? Cardi B, come out here. Let's work. After we work, then I'm going to get on you about what the fuck you said.
Do you think she going to have complications?
Yeah, she is. I mean, not that much. Not like that. It's just a whole bunch of fucking fuckery. She ain't going to have complications like that. I got a call to show 6ix9ine around. And at first I was like, okay, I'll do it. And then I had to think to myself, I can't do that. I seen that picture today. I don't know if that's him bent over, but it looks like you bent over, bro. Somebody's got you straddled, bent over, and like, what? as much as like, okay, it's like, I'm from the east side of Long Beach, you feel me? And Jabba Logan's from the north side. Like, I don't have beef with anybody, but our sides kind of conflict, you get me?
Yeah.
But when it comes to a point in a state of mind, like, okay, 6ix9ine, I don't know why the bro Jabba Loke is on you, but he has animosity toward you, so I'm not gonna rock on your good side. I'm from Long Beach at the end of the day, bro. Like, it don't matter. Jabba's from Long Beach, I'm from Long Beach. No matter what the east side have conflicted with his side, you feel me, or nothing. Jabba Loke, he's from Long Beach.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I will have his back before I will have an out-of-towner's back.
I feel you.
Period. So it's like, I can't even sit there and be like, okay, 6ix9ine, I'm going to show you around. Because yeah. I guarantee the first place I was going to take him was Long Beach.
Yeah.
If I was to show him around. So it's like, you know what I'm talking about? I can't do it.
What if he got 5 racks for
that's you? Okay. I can't do it. That 5 racks going to get spent, and I'm going to still be from Long Beach, California.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm talking about? It's like, no, I can't do it.
Yeah.
I don't get, like I said, you can't put no money price on how my mind is or the way I am.
Yeah.
You feel me? Like I said, I'd rather live life just like this, eating variety packs of noodles and smoking my weed and being with my son than to sell out for anything. Like,
yeah.
That's out.
Okay, so 6ix9ine got a little something going with your man.
What? Well, I just meant saying Jabba attack him. And then I see 6ix9ine, he like respond, laugh out loud on his post and shit. You feel what I'm talking about? But
so he not taking.
Jabba whole thing is he don't like this new age rap shit. Niggas with this gay shit, they promoting gayness and shit like it's supposed to be cool. Jabba's on some shit, take it back to the old school days, Snoop Dogg, Dr. Dre, Warren G type shit. You feel me?
Yeah.
Where niggas was understanding what it was you was rapping about.
Yeah.
Especially if you sitting here claiming gangs and shit are this and that and the other. You got shit looking weird, awkward now. You putting a whole different look on the gang culture.
Yeah.
You're out here with colorful hair and call yourself 6ix9ine and all this weirdo shit.
Man, Minnesota niggas wasn't having it though. They wasn't.
All this weirdo shit, you feel me? But you want to rap gangs and shit, that makes stuff look bad. Like, come on, my nigga, what?
Yeah.
Like, you can't do that. What are you doing?
Okay, so who is all these niggas supporting that shit in New York behind this nigga?
Some niggas who sold themselves short for money. I'm just be 100. I don't see any niggas in LA who will sit there and do that. You can't go to Nipsey and be like, hey, support this nigga in this song. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Nigga, the 6 hoes go, what the fuck? All right, cuz, this nigga tripping, cuz. Neighborhood. Like, yeah. They gonna let it be known fast, you feel me?
Yeah.
And like, he didn't come to L.A. and do no Notorious Blood Gang in L.A.
He was out here fucking with that other little nigga for a minute.
Oh.
The Trippy Red dude.
Oh, and Trippy Red is who? All right. Not like that. Like,
I understand he wasn't affiliated.
Trippie Red got into like one of my bros from Long Beach, so that would make me not affiliated with Trippie Red. You got into a nigga from Long Beach.
Yeah.
So I can't fuck with him like that.
I feel you, bro.
Like, I mean, Trippie Red also fucks with one of my long-term friends, Chris King. But it's like, once you say something about Long Beach, and it's a disrespectful thing, yeah. I can't fuck with you. I don't give a fuck who you are. You could be James Brown's son. You could be Michael Jackson back from the dead. You say something about Long Beach, it's like, first of all, Long Beach niggas stay to ourselves. You feel me?
Yeah.
And when we fuck with people, it's all out of love. So it's really not nothing to say really bad about Long Beach at all. You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
Even different hoods from Bloods, Crips, SAs, Asian, Cambodians, they fuck with Long Beach. Like, it's like, so if you have some weirdo shit to say about Long Beach or any of that matter, I don't give a fuck who they are from Long Beach. If they're from Long Beach, they're taking in to me as if, like, you my brother, sister, whatever. We all Long Beach.
I feel you.
You feel me?
Now, Tekashi never said nothing back to your man. He never responded.
Who?
To Jock.
Tekashi? Who's Tekashi?
The 6ix9ine.
That's his name?
Yeah.
That's his name? Tekashi? Oh, shoot. He sound like a TV.
Tekashi 6ix9ine.
Oh, yeah, that shit's out. What the fuck does Tekashi mean? Well, shit.
The 6ix9ine. Let's call it the 6ix9ine.
He be responding back like laugh out loud, this and that, but.
But he ain't never went on record.
I don't know. I'm going to go check and see. I'll go check and see. But I know.
It's
I know.
Bad.
Yeah, I just know that Job is not too. It's not just Job, though. It's a lot of other artists who's really not too pleased with like how he present himself, how he present a lot of shit. You feel me?
Yeah, it seems like it's going to be problems everywhere. It's real niggas.
Hey. All-Star Weekend is about to go up. So if you're from out of town, just make sure you try to tap in with Pookie. You know? Try to tap in with Pookie. You know, I do what I gotta do.
You're gonna try to help.
Yeah. I got pulled here and there everywhere almost, you know what I'm talking about? So, especially in these streets in LA, you know, a lot of people respect the grind and the hustle. So if you out here to grind and hustle, you know, just come out here and grind and hustle. But if you been putting shit out on your music, as if you this, that, and the other, I mean, now, you know, come face the music. You know, come face the music. Come face the music that
okay,
you put out.
Check this out, man.
Yeah.
I ain't gonna lie, man. I've been watching y'all niggas and y'all movement, man. I've been seeing the energy, man. Y'all got a lot of energy coming out, man. I'm feeling like, I don't know, man. It seemed like you turning into like the face of Long Beach out here. Is that what your mission was? Coming out like that?
That's good. That's a step.
Was you feeling like that?
I do want to take Long Beach on my back.
Yeah.
And what I mean by take Long Beach on my back, I want to be that person who actually united Long Beach as a whole. Everybody support each other no matter what the differences is. Mm-hmm. The end of the day, we still Long Beach, California.
Right.
562. You feel what I'm talking about? Mm-hmm. So it's like, niggas sleep on Long Beach. You hearing everybody's songs, oh, Long Beach. I mean, you hear L.A., Compton, Watts. You hear Inglewood in songs way more than you hear Long Beach. So it's like, I wonder why people don't really be shouting out Long Beach. And it's like, there's so much talent in my city.
Yeah.
We got to stop sleeping on each other, first of all. We got to stop hating on each other.
Okay.
We got to stop being in competition with one another. I don't feel as if we claim in the same city, we from the same area, there's no competition.
Okay.
Nigga, you grow. Okay. You grow.
Let me stop.
Mm-hmm.
Who are you?
I'm King of Turn Up, Pookie F'n Rude.
Where you from?
I'm from the east side of Long Beach. 19th of Myrtle.
Born and raised.
Actually, I'm going to take that back. I was born in Dominguez Hills. You know what I'm saying? That's basically Long Beach.
Yeah.
You feel me? My mama from Compton. So I was in Compton. You dig what I'm talking about? But raised in Long Beach. I'm from Long Beach. My daddy from Long Beach, the east side.
Okay.
You dig me? My mama from Compton. So I only went to school in Compton until about second grade. After that, all Long Beach.
All Long Beach.
19th and Myrtle. Cherry and 7th. On the north side of Long Beach. 61st and South. You know, like... Man.
Okay. Now, what was your first music like? What first music was hitting you to fuck with you and, you know, affected you?
Honestly, the music stuff came... This is what people don't know. I used to do a lot of stuff in church.
Okay.
And then I played the violin since second grade. So it's like, I was always a instrument person.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? From the drums at church and the violin. But as I got older, and I did choir. But as I got older, I thought all that shit started being corny. Like, what the fuck? Like, I'm going to be real, you feel me? So I was like, what the fuck am I doing this for? So I stopped. I stopped just doing it. Not like doing it. I still do it here and there, but I just stopped doing it at the church and all that. And I just started doing more so dancing and entertaining shit like that.
Yeah, I'm seeing the energy. You
know?
Yeah.
So it's like all that shit just came in one mush.
Yeah.
From the dancing to the music. Then churches will help me get rid of all my like shyness and fear, stage fright. Because, you know, you got Easter plays and Christmas plays and doing all that at church, singing in choir. And then it's like, you know, as I got older, I started just tapping in more into my talent.
Yeah.
And I just became the party guy in high school and shit. After high school, became the party guy.
Okay.
You know, I never knew hosting or doing parties and shit was in my lane. Because I was supposed to be in college.
Right.
And I got in a fight. Lost my scholarships, and I had academic scholarships.
Right.
You feel me? Computer engineer, psychology, and English major.
Uh-huh.
So it's like, I was training myself to get ready for college.
Yeah.
And I got in a fight, boom. Well, that's when I moved to the IE. I moved to the IE in 2006 after I graduated. I graduated in June, moved to IE like July, August 2006. Started networking out there, meeting people, boom, boom, boom. Super Bowl 2007. That was February 7th, Super Bowl 2007. I got convicted because I got in a fight.
Okay.
You feel me? I got in a fight, and it caused great bodily injury on the person I was fighting.
Was he deceased or did he survive?
Nah, he survived, but it fractured the left side. Boom.
Alright, mic check.
Yeah.
Okay.
I fractured the left side of his face.
Okay.
You know, it was a fucked up situation.
Okay.
I didn't even go to fight. I went to actually be the mediator, make sure everything was solid and cool.
Do we have cognitive impairment? Is he still mentally 100?
He's solid, just having sight problems.
Okay.
In that one eye, but I mean, you know, that's neither here nor there. That happened.
Flowing well.
You know, I learned my lesson, but it's just like, now it's like, that's what set my life in a whole different direction. I went to jail and shit.
Okay.
Thank God I didn't get no strike or anything, but they gave me a felony.
Yeah.
And all my skills of working is customer service, dealing with people.
Right.
And like jobs, they really frowned upon that. I had a violent crime.
Right.
They didn't even give me a chance of the day, so I'm like, you know what? Fuck all this working. Fuck working for somebody. I still tried to get jobs and shit.
Yeah.
Stuck it out, and I was like, I'm gonna just do what I gotta do.
Okay.
So I started investing all my energy and time in me.
Yeah.
And when I got out of jail around the time, that's when the dream was popping. So I made songs. I mean, I made my parties after him. Okay. Like, he had a song called Purple Kisses. I did a party called Purple Kisses.
Yeah.
And Lick Me Like a Lollipop.
Right.
Those two parties let my name be known in the Inland Empire.
Okay.
You feel what I'm saying? Then I started linking up with different people. My boy Damo, he went to Colony High. They had this little street team called Go Hard. That's when I met my nigga Jay Hard.
Okay.
And Jay Hard and I, we was throwing parties. And that's when these two niggas came in the picture right here.
Yeah.
And just all a whole... thing just came together, mush. Then we just start throwing parties in the IE. We threw this big event called Clash of the Cities. And this is about the time YG started popping, but this was AIM days. We was popping on AIM and shit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? We was the first people to bring YG to the IE and have audio push. This when they was booming, had they shit going. They was at the party. But this was before anybody was big, but at the time, like, it's still on YouTube. Y'all go look at it, Clash of the Cities Part 2. It's all on there and everything. You'll see you got people from Pasadena, people from L.A., people from the Bay. It's like people from everywhere that came to that party in Fontana.
Yeah.
You dig me? So then we start really making noise. We start making noise and throwing parties in the IE, boom. Had the IE popping. We learned our lesson from house parties. Then started doing our own events. And everybody just saturated.
Okay.
After a few years, everybody just got on, got their own ways. And then we all just grew in our own lanes, you know what I mean? And for some reason, I stayed relevant. 10 years later, this is 10 years later.
Through all social media,
everything, I stayed relevant as that go-to guy to promote. I'll hit Pookie up for connects. So I built my own lane by loads of mistakes, paying attention to my mistakes, redoing my actions, and actually changing what I did that was a mistake at one point in time. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And it's like, now it's like I built my own platform. Like, I got people who's my age, but they got little brothers and sisters that come up to me. Hey, Pookie, my brother used to fuck with your parties. He said, fuck with you. Damn, I'm getting referrals for people to come fuck with me safely.
Yeah.
Or to come fuck with me in a way they could be you could trust somebody you fuck with. Like, I've never really did it for a whole bunch of money or to break people. That's one dude right there who used to get on my head. Like, Pookie, you too nice. Yeah. You give deals too much, this and that. Woo, woo, woo. We used to get arguments. People remember, I used to always come out, and I never wanted to do it, but I used to always come out and tell people, y'all got to pay. Woo, woo, woo. But niggas know, like, let's talk to Pookie. I guarantee you, let us in free. I was that nigga, big hearted. I was never in it for, like, taking everybody money. I just wanted to always turn shit up.
Right.
And as long as I know I got people feeling good, I was happy. You feel me? So it's like, I showed everybody respect. People show me respect. So it's like, I started going with that. I started off mean as fuck on the mic, talking shit.
Yeah.
Like, to the point one girl snatched the cord out the mic and I popped out the backpack with a cordless and kept talking shit on her ass. You feel me?
Yeah.
We got to the point we were shutting down all the little bar and grills venues, Shalimar Gardens. it was a spot, Club 401. Like, we was on a whole bunch, our main event in Fontana, like,
yeah.
The shit, the Pomona Fox Theater in San Bernardino and in Pomona, like, we was making standpoints in IE, like, damn, they really doing their shit. But then it's like, when you're not business savvy, a lot of shit just crumble. And now, yeah, so it happened.
Be careful with that chair, that motherfucker.
I know you good.
Yeah.
If we wasn't business savvy and the shit crumbled on us, you feel me? But then we start gaining business the right way. Y'all want to touch this up? We start gaining business the right way and learning what the fuck we had to do.
Right.
You feel me? But me, I always made some type of hustle out of hustle. So when I was doing the party shit, I made people feel good about wanting to work and promote. I created this shit called Milk Money. You feel me? My cousin Ray, shout out to Ray, he got a clothing line called Milk Money. So he was like, what's the fastest way I could get this out in the streets, this and that? This one I knew I was an innovator with ideas and I could make money out of nothing. You feel what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And he was like, Milk Money. I was like, well, listen, I got a lot of people that come to parties. You get, like, it was shirts like that. It just had the logo and the name, Milk Money. I'm like, give me a whole bunch of them shirts. I'm gonna make sure everybody get a shirt who promotes Milk Money. We're gonna put Milk Money on all the flyers. Milk Money on her street team. I'm just make a whole thing Milk Money, Milk Money. And I did that with no instructions or nothing, but it was big.
Yeah.
For about 2 summers, Milk Money, Milk Money, Milk Money, all in IE. Had everybody walking around with the cow in the chain. Milk Money, Milk Money.
Yeah.
You feel me?
Yeah.
But then once again, when you do shit with not being business savvy, you just do shit off of thought. Shit fuck up. I had people within the crew fucking each other. We was young.
Right.
You feel me? So it's like it started a whole bunch of shit, but then stopped. I'm responsible for a lot of people's families right now. To be real, like, a lot of people met their baby daddy or baby mama or their person they're with now, they met them through, like, a lot of shit we had going on. And it's just, like, the growth of it, though. Everybody matured and grown up. So now it's, like, little shit like that kept my name going.
Right.
You feel me? Kept my name going. Pookie, 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 Pookie. I'm like, damn, shit. I put Milk Money in videos. And I start. That's when I start noticing the shit I'm doing. I'm like, hold on. I'm not just a promoter. You feel me? Yeah. Keep in mind, the hosting shit that ain't took off yet. I was just hosting shit, just talk shit on the mic. Now it's like I'm tapping into my talents. I'm tapping into what I could do. Okay, I promote. Hold on. Now I'm putting together other businesses with the promotion I'm already doing. Hold on.
Yeah.
I'm adding to this. Hold on. Let's start booking the homies now, this few years later. YG, that's still my dog. Okay, yeah. YG, you big now. Let's start booking you at shows. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to make people pay to be on the same stage as you.
Yeah.
You dig me?
Yeah.
Now, don't get me wrong. They've been doing pay to play. But I made it more personal. I made people feel more of a personal effect with the pay to play. People give us the whole event. Pookie give us the whole adventure. We pay. He allows us to meet the artists. He allows us to do our shit. He allows us to do this, that, and the other. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it's like, let me keep doing this. Now I'm about to make my events pay for themselves.
Yeah.
I booked the venue, booked the artists. Now people want to come out and showcase their music. You got to book yourself by paying this fee.
Yeah.
And still make sure they guarantee people.
Yeah.
So start working. You dig me?
Yeah.
And I start using my shows as my platform to get a lot of my promotions done. So when I host, I get promotions done. I just do my shit. But then I realize, like, when I host, I really turn people up.
Yeah.
I noticed the atmosphere of the party changed from when the DJ just playing the music. He could be playing hits and going in versus to when I touch that mic and start talking. Now he playing hits going in and I'm going up. Now the club feeling the vibe. It's like, oh, shit. So then I start thinking more. Let me put this club voice on CDs and people tapes and on a mixtape. I could host shit. So I did that.
Yeah.
Start hosting shit. Like, oh, shit. You dig what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
And after that, I just like, okay, I can promote artists. I ain't promote artists. So from me promoting artists, being around all this shit, I'm already musically inclined. I don't watch TV like that. I read, so I got a lot of shit that I know. So I was like, you know, I'm going to just fuck around and start freestyling when I go to these studio sessions and be bored. I sat in T-Fly's studio from the start of his singing career to when he got plaques. He'll tell you himself. I sat in there and made sure I hit goals on promoting. But while I'm in there with people like DJ Quick, Nipsey Hussle. You know what I'm talking about? They in there recording, rapping. I'm seeing how niggas is doing they shit. Man, okay, that's how you record. Okay. All right. So it's really just about feeling it. You got to really feel this shit. Mm-hmm. I'm not a rapper. But I can't vibe out the beat, so I start running with that. You dig me? When I was in jail, when I went to jail, I was a nigga that was in jail beating on the bunk, making everybody feel good and time go by fast. Just thinking of shit.
Yeah.
I got a song in jail that I thought of with my nigga B.A. He from the Bay.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? His name is B.A. He from Mob out there, and I was locked up with him. And we became real close to this day. I talked to him. He talked to me. Check up on his family. Check up on my son type shit. You feel me?
Yeah.
And we got this song, and we was on the beat. I was like, she got that bubble gum. She got that bubble gum. You know what I'm saying? And it went hard as fuck. Like, everybody that was in our dorm, hey, play that, do that bubble gum. Do that bubble gum.
Niggas performing that
what?
Shit.
Way in 2007, I'm thinking to myself, like, okay, I'm in jail. Got niggas in jail rocking to this, and I don't even do music. And I still ignored it then.
Yeah.
You dig what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Every artist that I promoted and pushed, they made some type of noise. People know who they are.
Yeah.
I have an ear for music, and I still ignored the fact that that's so. It's like, okay, I was on this Ball Up tour. Ball Up is basically the new N1, and I'm the voice of Ball Up. I'm the one, oh, shit, you got crossed. Oh, goddamn.
Okay.
Oh, look at the professor. Oh, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Bone collector. Like, I'm that nigga that's out there talking.
Right.
So we on the tour, and I'm mad because we in Nebraska, and I didn't have no weed from California.
Right.
So we're in the car. We listen to instrumentals. Boom. I was like, oh. When they smoke my shit, the homie Jones, the homie NASA, we all in there just vibing out. And we just freestyling some shit, and the beat came on. That's how I came with the song, ooh. But I kept saying, I'm not a rapper, though. And it got catchy. I'm like, ooh, shit.
Yeah.
I'm like, okay. So I got thinking to myself, I promote all these artists, you know. I did Problem Promotion, T-Fly, you know what I'm saying? I did Fanatics, you know what I'm saying, AV. My nigga, Mr. White Dog. I'm doing all these people promotions, and I'm like, I'm the center of it all. I'm on stage with all of them, and they shows go up. with or without me, but it goes up on another level when I'm hosting it with them and it's right. going up, you know? Right. So I start thinking to myself, I could really do some shit. I'm not a rapper though. I still ignored it. Way in Nebraska.
Yeah.
Came back home. It was a YouTube. People was like, Pookie, you know what? You should make that a song. So I did that. I always do what people feel I should do. The people is who's going to pay for the shit.
Right,
the people is who's going to keep your name floating.
Right.
One thing that I noticed about my promotion and shit when I was doing my shit, people always was attracted to my dance videos.
Okay.
I always caused attention with that. So now I start interacting. Some of the homie songs I'm promoting are people that pay for promotions. Start interacting that with my dance videos.
Okay.
So I'm just setting up my platform. I'm like, damn, I got all this shit going in one. I can really do some shit.
Yeah.
You feel me?
Mm-hmm.
Not to mention I got my radio station. So I'm like, oh. So I'm just building all my promotion shit. So I finally took it serious. I got all these songs I've been recording with people. Just for the fuck of it, going in there. I don't write shit, just freestyle, but it sound good as fuck.
That's all.
You know what?
That's what counts.
I'm going to collect all these songs and put the mixtape together. I'm not a rapper, though. So I did it. And it was about like 30-some songs at first.
And that's what we got right here.
That's what we got right there. And I knocked it down 11 songs. You know what I'm saying? Actually, I knocked it down 9 songs. So now it's 21 songs on that track right there. You know, so on that mixtape, it's 21 songs on that mixtape. I'm not a rapper though. And song 1 through 21 slaps. You feel me? And I let you know I'm not a rapper. So anybody that got that passed judgment, oh, this shit weak. You open to say that I'm not a rapper.
Amen.
And I'm not going to get hurt by it because I guarantee you're not going to say that anything on there is weak. And it's like now, it's like I'm about to just focus. 2018, don't get me wrong, Rude Effect, that's my shit. That's my company. Just go. That's me. I'm just go, Mr. White Dog. That ain't going nowhere. You feel me? But at the end of the day, I have to set that platform now for me. I set it for everybody else.
Who's Mr. White Dog?
Mr. White Dog. That's my brother, MTG. Mr. White Dog. That's my dog. That's the loke that y'all missing out on. That's the Crip y'all need to listen to from Harbor City. That's my brother. He ain't going nowhere. He just right now. He just God is just building him to be a better person. You feel me? But he's about to be out this year. Mr. White Dog, y'all check him out. MTG. Yes. MTG, Mr. White Dog from Harbor City. You dig me? And it's like way back then, 2013, 2014. Hey, you can spark that. 2013, 2014, I did the features. I lined them up. Joe Moses, Nipsey Hussle, RJ. You dig what I'm saying? He got the feature with Darrow. Like Fanatics. I lined this shit up. AD. I lined this shit up in a way to where it's like, way back then, Dog is already connected. And it's just kind of crazy how he went to jail the way he went to jail. And he's been in jail. And it's like people try to sleep. You probably seen him on my page. I was promoting him.
I seen him. I was talking to him at Complex
Con. When? That had to be 2013. That had to be 2013.
The first Complex.
Yeah, that had to be 2013 when we had the booth setting up with the mixtapes.
Nah,
it was a Tunnel Vision mixtapes.
How long you been like that?
About 2.5 years, almost 3. Wait, yeah, 2000. Yeah, God damn, it's been 3 years. He been locked up. He went to jail 2014. Dog went to jail 2014, 15. So it's been 3 years, almost 3 years. Yeah.
Yeah, I seen that nigga. I can't remember. I seen him at the Long Beach Sports Arena though.
Dog, he been doing his shit. Don't get me wrong.
Yeah.
It's like that was destined. God put that together like a puzzle piece. You feel me?
Yeah.
And dog, it's like, when people say loyalty, I show my loyalty. I'm not restricted to work with anyone. I can work with anybody I want to.
Right.
You dig what I'm talking about?
Okay. But, hold on.
Okay.
I
like basically, I can work with anybody, you feel me?
Yeah.
And I choose to work with the people I work with. But then when it comes down to the nitty gritty, White Dog is who I'm loyal to with this shit. You feel what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
The reason why is that because White Dog came out of nowhere. You know what I'm saying? White Dog came out of nowhere, and he actually just said, you know what, let's make this shit happen. Let's work. You got the promo skills, and I got the bars. I could put the money behind anything I need. I just need you to support me and work with me. So let's go. So he showed me his loyalty when it was like people don't know. Like I never expose none of my downfall when I'm doing bad. People don't know out there, this is the first time they're going to hear this right now, my followers and everybody. People don't know I was homeless for 3 years, bro. I was sleeping in my car, house to house.
Like real life homeless,
but I would never let it show. Because I always had people out there who would look out for me. You feel me? But I got a pride problem, bro. I would never ask people for help. Even when I'm doing bad, I still won't let you know I'm doing bad. You feel what I'm saying? And I never let that be over my head or be something that held me down. Me actually having to find somewhere secluded to park my car and then go to sleep and then wake up. You feel what I'm saying? But I was smart with it. I wake up and go like to the gym or something.
Yeah.
Work out, then take a shower there.
Yeah.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
And then get myself together.
Yeah.
You dig what I'm saying? I always had places where I could go and I had clothes put up or something. Like, I set my life up according to how I was living.
Right.
It was a reason why I was probably homeless. I didn't need no bills at the time. I was too much on the move getting my name out there.
Yeah.
So I never looked at it as like, oh, I'm homeless. I just looked at it like I'm not stationed right now.
Yeah.
I don't have my own whereabouts to go, but I always had a house where I had a key to. Don't get me wrong. You feel me? I had a house I had a key to. It just wasn't my shit.
Right.
So it's like, no, I like, it's not me. I done slept on people's couches, and I'm not afraid to admit it.
Yeah.
I didn't, but it's like, I was never a freeloader.
Right.
If I stayed at your house, I always made sure I paid a bill and helped you with rent.
Right.
I did something to contribute anywhere I was at. I could be at your house probably 2 days out the week and then be on tour for about 4 months and come back to your house and still helped you with rent and bills and everything. I wasn't even there.
Okay, so right now, you 100% eating off of all entertainment
and hustle. Yeah, I'm eating off of what I allow myself to do, what I apply my mind to. Like, I get paid off people coming to me and talking to me for advice.
I feel you.
And it's like, I did all them sacrifices to get to this level. People just think, oh, this shit happened overnight. No, nigga, I've been dancing on stage. I've been sweating. I've been leaving outfits at people's houses and buying new clothes just for that event of the day, just so I could keep my presence and my appearance who it is. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I've been cheering people up. I've been connecting the dots. I've been that silent assassin. You know, you got a whole group full of ninjas, and then boom, a smoke bomb go up, and you hear all this. You feel me? All these other ninjas is out of breath, but there's one ninja who really did everything, but he out.
Yeah.
I'm that nigga.
Okay.
I'm that assassin. You won't see me, but the work is going to be done, but you got other niggas breathing hard like they did that. Like,
yeah.
You dig me? And they take that credit, and I just sit back and watch. I'm not a credit-seeking nigga. I just want everybody to know that my work is done right. I want everybody to know that I get the job done, and time is going to present itself for me to show it. And I've always been patient. This nigga, both of these niggas could tell you, they're the behind-the-scenes niggas. I'm not going to ever expose their names, nothing. I'm just like, those niggas, they'll let you know. We seen Pookie take losses. We seen Pookie get paid only what we could give them. They'll tell you out their mouth, and I accept it. And I came back and did the work even better than the last time. I've always had that drive, like, fuck it, let me just do my job. Let me do my job. Y'all smoking? I always thought, like, let me do my job. Let me do my job. I didn't went to San Diego by myself, stayed out there for 3 months. Only knew one person out there, but I made do what I had to do while I was out there. You dig what I'm talking about?
Right, right.
My cousin ended up being in the Navy. So he had Navy living. He had his own spot. He gave me a key. He was always on base. So yeah. I had his apartment 3 months to myself and his car.
Right.
Driving back and forth from San Diego to Long Beach, San Diego to IE. As long as I kept up on the gas and all that. And I did my shit, so I made it work.
Hustle.
I went to Texas by myself. That's when I got introduced to South by Southwest.
Hustling.
Okay. Doing my shit, making my name. Anywhere I went, making my name known. It's like, I never had a doubt in my mind that it was for nothing.
Right.
My child's mother, I'm not going to say she didn't believe in it, but she didn't feel it was worth my time.
Okay.
She wanted me to apply my time elsewhere.
Hold up.
Yeah. And yeah. Like, you know, my child's mother, you feel me? I don't like to say baby mama. My child's mother, I'm not saying she didn't believe in me. She just didn't feel I was applying my time in the right areas. You feel what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
It is February. I said January. But yeah, She felt I should have been doing something else in my time. Okay. She felt I should have been doing something else. And I just used to keep telling her, like, you know what? I can't allow myself to work for nobody. She used to hate when I say that. I can't work for nobody. Why would I give 100% of my time and only get paid about 40 to 60% of earnings? You feel me? I want 100% of my earnings for 100% of my time.
Right.
Only way you can get that is if you apply your time 100% in yourself. Yeah. So I did sacrifice, nigga. I went the farthest from promoting shows to doing my promotion, promoting motherfucking clothes. And I was boosting clothes, nigga, out the trunk. I'm not playing.
Right.
You dig what I'm talking about?
Get money.
Get money. My first big show I ever got put on was the one I did at the Los Angeles Coliseum. And it was the Summer Explosion.
Yeah.
You dig me? My son was just born. No, before that, rewind that. Arizona, the old Cardinal Stadium. I took my child's mother with me. I was like, hopefully this opened her eyes. We drove. Nigga, we drove to Arizona. Got out there, did a show with E-40. This is when Miguel was first coming out. Nobody knew the fuck Miguel was.
Yeah.
You feel me? Travis Porter. This one, Travis Porter was popping. It was booming. Travis Porter, Mr. Racks on Racks on Racks. This is all them. This is all that time. You feel what I'm saying? E-40. I had Too Short, Lil Jon.
Man, you think I said we had some time, shit?
Mm-hmm. Bro, I've been around.
Yeah,
you feel me? I've been around. It's like I started young, so that made it better. I'm only 29. I just turned 29 on Thanksgiving.
Okay, so,
you know what I'm saying?
Now, the concept. Okay, when I seen you, you know, because like I said, I observe Greedo, you know, I've been keeping my eye on Greedo through the years.
Yeah.
So when I seen y'all set up, and it was the, you know, it looked like some professional hype man type shit. Now, was that what you was going for? Like, I'm just, this is my services in this moment for this man.
Nah, hell nah. I'm gonna tell you how that all started. Let me end this and come right back. Hey, y'all. I'm coming right back because I got to end this. But, nigga, we got 172 people watching. So I got to go back behind. They watching. They tuned in.
Okay.
So, basically, the whole thing with Greedo.
Yeah.
Greedo is not a new friend or anything.
Right.
Greedo been around for double-digit years.
Right.
He didn't always go by 03 Greedo.
Right.
It was Greedy Giddy.
Right.
And that's my bro. Like, him and Trill used to always be. If you seen him, you seen Trill.
Right.
You feel me? Trilliano. Shout out to my nigga Trilliano. But Greedo been doing music. So it's like, Greedo used to always hit me and went, like, one thing about Greedo, he was never that type of nigga to invade your space. He'll let you do your thing.
Right.
He did his thing all the time. Either way it go, no matter what, even if you denied to fuck with Greedo, he'll still do his own thing.
Right.
You know what I'm talking about?
Right.
So it's like, he was doing this shit. He always tell me, Pookie, I'm doing music. Fuck with me. I always listen to his music. People wasn't gravitating to Greedo music at the time.
Yeah.
His style of music, his flow, he always had his own type of generic way of doing his music. His own way.
Yeah.
You feel me? That's why it was generic. It was bred from him.
Yeah.
His own way of doing it. So it's like, people wasn't really gravitating to it in our area.
Right.
But elsewhere they were.
Right.
And Greedo, he hopped around. He bounced around when everywhere. Atlanta, North Carolina, the Bay. You know what I'm talking about?
Right.
Fucking with people, like really fucking with people and getting his name known, just him being him.
Right.
You feel me? So when I'm hearing Greedo's shit now and I heard it, I'm in Vegas. The homie Mills play his shit. You feel me? The homie Mills play Greedo's shit. And I'm like, oh, shit. This nigga's going up.
Right.
That's Greedo? Nigga, that's Greedy. That's goddamn. So I did a video to one of his shits. I was in Vegas and I was turning up. It went viral. It went viral. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
And when it went viral, I'm like, oh, shit. This shit go. People gravitating to it.
Yeah.
And I already do hosting and hype and shit up all the time. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it's like, I hit Greedo up. I ended up doing a few shows. He invited me to a few shows, but I also had some books, so I wasn't ever there to go. But I seen him when he did his shit. He was always on stage by himself doing his shit. I was like, damn, bro, I need to go hype bro up. He already got the crowd knowing it because they know his music. Imagine how they are if they know the Greedo I know. Greedo know how to dance and all that.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm talking about?
Right.
So I was like, I got to just bring some parts of that Greedo out. So
yeah,
I booked them at a show. The Mozzie and Greedo show, I had them at that show.
I remember that. I peeped that.
I did another show with them. Famous Dex was supposed to be there, but Famous Dex ended up showing up.
I peeped that.
I had Greedo. Greedo just came. Basically, like, people got a view of the film. Even before that, he was doing the big show. He did an observatory show. Somebody brought him out. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
He did a big show, like a smoke comp show. He did some shit. He was rocking the stage. You feel me? So I did the event, Greedo and Mozzie, boom. Got on that stage. It's like, it wasn't no rehearsal or nothing. It's like the chemistry was there, boom. Ah. Same with Mr. White Dog. When me and Mr. White Dog get on the stage, it's electrifying. I say big ass words like that because I mean it. You feel me?
Okay, so same with Greedo. So yo, like, that's what I'm saying, man. Like,
the whole hosting shit, that just come natural with me. That just come natural. Like I said, with White Dog is the same thing I felt with Greedo, same thing I felt with T-Fly. When I'm on the stage, any artist, I don't have to know your shit. I can just whoop, tap in.
That's the whole thing. You just know how to get the crowd.
That's that whole,
yeah,
that whole being in tune with music, this whole upcoming with it. And it's like, I've been hosting so much. I know, like, when a rapper is rapping, I observe. One thing I do, I read the crowd. My whole objective is to make sure the crowd is fucking with us. You feel me? At any time in a matter, at least if they not fucking with us, they fucking with me. So right. I read the crowd. Just how I read the crowd, I read the artist. So I can tell when the artist is getting winded. So I come in. Hey, oh, or what you say or some part
right,
of the song.
Right.
And it just, people be like, did y'all rehearse that? No. I get your artist's attention. You might see me and Greedo going back and forth, facing each other. Me and White Dog used to do it all the time. It's just like, it's a time when you're performing, you feel a certain way. Just like when you're in the streets.
Yeah.
You dig me?
Yeah.
You got street knowledge. What we call this stage knowledge.
Yeah.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
And it's like, that's what make you a great performer. And it's like, my hosting, it's not my hosting that catch people's attention. It's my performance while hosting.
Right.
It's the fact that I'm performing, but I'm actually giving you a job. I got crowd control because I perform and you could call it hypnotize the crowd to follow my instructions because they're following the whole performance of what I'm doing.
Right.
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it's like, it's all a math and a science to this shit. You can't just get on stage, hey, turn up, all right. Niggas sound dumb just getting on the mic, grabbing it. Right. You feel me?
You feeling the energy of the crowd and working with what you got at the time. You don't know what you facing.
I don't never know what crowd I'm going to go in front of. Nothing. I've seen niggas get bottles thrown at them, booed, and I follow right behind that same person. And get the most love.
And know exactly what to like, say, damn. When to say it.
Oh, God. You got to make the crowd feel as if, okay, I'm one. I paid this money to be here. Acknowledge me.
Yeah.
Period.
Yeah.
I remember when I used to be in the crowd, I wanted to be acknowledged. Like, I see somebody, oh, shit, that's the homie on stage. Hey, yo. And I can see them look right over me while they talking on the mic. Yo, what's up?
Right.
That shit used to make me feel like, damn, what the fuck?
Right.
Like, I know you seen me.
Right. But you see them bitches over there.
But you can say something to them bitches right there. They don't even know you, bro. I know your moms.
Yeah.
But you overlook me. So it's like, I've been that person that, oh, what's up, bro? That was a good show, man. And I told people, like, oh, I know him. And then I look stupid.
Yeah.
Because they looked at me like a regular nigga. You feel me? Like, oh. And the people I told that I know, you don't know that nigga like that. You dig me? So, like, now I'm in a position to where people, they notice me.
Yeah.
People that I don't even know notice me, but I never make anyone feel as if I don't know them. Hey, yo, Pookie, what's going on? Hey, what's the deal, bro? How you been? And I embrace them.
Love.
Because I've been that person who really knew somebody.
Right.
You feel me?
Right.
I don't remember everything. I remember a lot. I don't remember everything, but I don't ever want nobody to feel as if I don't know them.
Right.
Or as if I never acknowledge them or never knew they existed. Nothing. Like, what the fuck? I'm a regular human being. It's just that my abilities and my skills and my talent got me to work with different people that you guys idolize or you guys look up to.
Right.
You dig me?
Yeah.
It's nothing different than what people do that clock in every day to work.
Yeah.
Because the nigga at Foot Locker, I could be his biggest fan because that nigga hooks me the fuck up.
Right.
You dig me?
Yeah.
Not knowing that three of his employees fuck with me and they really like me and they know me. So I embrace all that shit. Like,
yeah.
You dig what I'm talking about? Like, yeah. I embrace all that shit. Like, Like, me and my boy Radio did a song called Do It For The Culture. Now, I believe we really do shit for the culture.
Yeah.
You dig what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
I don't mind being in public and being a regular dude. Like I said, I would never sell myself short just because of amount of money. I will always do what I want to do. I will think how I want to think. And if it involves me living a regular, normal life, I'm happy with that. As long as I got a variety of noodles to choose from. And they don't have to have shrimp.
What's your celebrity level right now, you think?
Like, I don't have a celebrity level.
No, listen. What's your recognition level in the street?
Honestly speaking, you will have to ask somebody else that because they bring it to my attention.
Like, as you walk around, what's your average selfies go to the mall?
Well, people, the way people perceive me is like they give me like a respect level. Some people are intimidated. They think I'm going to shoot on them or they think I'm going to say something rude until they really open it. And they're like, dang, cool. But people don't come with the selfie shit, but I get a lot of recognition. Like, oh, shit, you're Pookie.
I get that more than normal.
I get that a lot. Right. Like, a lot. And I embrace that shit. I embrace the fuck out of it. I make them feel like they the famous person, if they so call it famous. Right. I don't see it as famous. I just see it as I'm doing my job. I'm setting examples. I'm sitting here making mistakes, and I'm learning from mistakes, and I'm helping people not make those mistakes.
Yeah.
I'm just going hard at what I'm doing. I'm helping people enjoy life. I'm giving people a vibe that most people are afraid. I go up to gangbangers. Niggas, gangbangers can tell you they probably in a position they don't even want to laugh. But I, damn, why are y'all looking like y'all about to murder somebody? God damn.
Right.
I enter the room like that.
You bringing good energy to the table. Man, good vibe.
That's all I know, bro. Like, you know how bad I be wanting to break down for shit, but why? Why spend all that energy and that use of energy to break down for something that's bad when you could just sit there and put it behind you and keep going hard and be happy for something that's going to be good in the outcome, in the long run? You feel what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
So it's like, I think different. I do got an attitude problem when it's stupid shit.
Yeah.
When people don't use common sense.
Right.
And it's very common nowadays to lack common sense. So that's the shit that makes me mad.
Right.
I get mad at typical shit. I get mad at when females are feeling disrespected because you decided to wear a dress that hooks your ass with no panties and a nigga did what a nigga is supposed to do, react.
Right.
You dig me?
Yeah.
I get mad at stupid shit like that. If you want a reaction as a lady, then present yourself as a lady.
Yeah.
Because if you twerking ass, shaking ass, I can see your booty cheeks all the time.
That's what I
titties, nipples. Oh, I'm coming at you like that. I want to fuck. I'm not going to approach you like, hi, how was your day? Fuck all that. Hi, how you doing? Can we fuck? You can't get mad at that.
Yeah.
And I just want people to know the realization of life and what they do for themselves. The way people see you are the way they're going to react to you.
Yeah.
You digging me?
Yeah.
And it's like, it be gangster niggas, gangbangers, all that. People that don't fuck with the crew of people I hang with, but they when they see me, it's a whole level of different respect. And I love that because I'm not a nigga that's out here looking for attention. Yeah. I'm a nigga out here trying to make 100 people smile today. I'm that nigga. I'm the nigga out here that's taking your talent and making a price tag behind it. And I want my 20-30%. You dig me?
Yeah.
For being the engine to have it going.
Trying to get money.
Come on, man. That's who I am.
For what I did.
That's who I am, period. That's what I want to do. Like, I want to get to the money. Like, I want us all to get some money together. What, yeah, no?
Which phone is that?
I don't know. You got a lot of phones. You Trap King.
Which phone?
You know what I mean? That it's like, I don't know how to be anything or anyone else.
Yeah.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
I talk to everybody the same. And it's just like, I just know how to be me. I have a problem with keeping it to 100. I think that's why I'm still single now.
Okay.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
But I'm not in a state of mind to be like, oh, I want to be in a relationship. I do want a relationship. Don't get me wrong.
Yeah.
But relationships and all that shit is too overrated.
Yeah.
People get titles and they start acting different ways. I'm the type of nigga, like, if you could flow with my lifestyle, if you could adapt to how I live, then I could fuck with you in the long run and we could build something. You know what I mean? And it's like, females don't understand. They meet me because they're attracted by the way I might set off a flirtatious vibe or this, that, or other. But then it's like, females try to get with you, and then they try to change that about you. They don't want you to be flirtatious anymore. First of all, just how I got your attention, there's loads of money out there who attention I'm getting, so why stop that because you feel somebody's gonna come and take your position. Be secure with that, you got that position, and just lock it. And it's hard to find females like that, you feel me? So I was like, I'd rather just incline my grind and keep doing this shit,
yeah,
than to deal with this. You know, you fuck a female and they don't understand, you know, we can fuck with each other on an intimate level, but this emotional shit and all this, oh, me, like all that shit.
Well, you seem to have some game about yourself. You're dealing with a whole lot of bitches here and there, man. And you know that's what this show is really all about. Niggas checking in, needing assistance from bitches to help and shit like that. And we try to do the best we can.
I call them bananas.
Amen.
I call them bananas.
That's what you call bitches?
I call them bananas. Bananas.
Why you call them bananas?
Because I'm a gorilla. I see myself as a gorilla.
And you eating a banana.
And they get peeled. They get split. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes that muffin might get stuffing. You done talking about the banana spread? You never know. You dig me?
Yeah.
Either way, they could be a good or they could be bad. You know what I'm saying? You got good bananas out here and you got these bad bananas.
Okay. Well, we're traditional, man.
You just call them bitches.
This bitches, man. So you understand what I'm saying? Very clear. You feel the energy. And I want to be... when I talk like that, man, it's not with no disrespect to bitches because I respect bitches at the
you
just, highest
see,
level.
You make it sound so smooth. You know the bitches.
At the highest level, listen, because I believe in real bitches. You see that shirt right there?
Real, yeah, real bitches.
Real ass bitch.
Real ass
that's
bitch,
like,
yeah.
I feel like that's a title of honor for a bitch. Like, that's a real ass bitch. Like, that's a real ass nigga. Like, it's the same thing. He's a weak bitch. Now, that's, I put an adjective in front of that. You feel me? Now, it's bad. Like,
you's a weak bitch.
Yeah. That's where I'm at with it. I don't want y'all to misunderstand.
All right. So, for your show, I'm going to say bitches.
That's what we do on here, man. And if you listen to all my catalog and shit, you'll find that that's.
Yeah.
I've been consistent over the years.
With the bitches.
I've been consistent.
Somebody in my life, they knew you and recognized your logo and shit.
Oh, for real?
They said you came to their school and shit. Salute. That's what's up. You know, we got the bitch king in here. You know what I'm talking about?
Man, you know what? It's all love, like I say. And we do have some emails that... some motherfuckers sent in. I usually respond to a couple of them, and I mean, you know, welcome to give your thoughts on the emails if you're down.
Yeah, let's go. Come on,
you with that?
Let's go.
All right, and then I want to come back and I want to address some more.
All right,
some more of your stuff. But I know niggas gonna get mad at me if I don't do this, and we gonna do it. Look like we gonna be like a. We covering some time.
We covering
and that's good.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
That's good. I like what you're doing, man. You flowing and going.
Appreciate it, man.
Yeah.
Well, it's for the people, man. You know what I'm talking about? We gotta do this for the people.
Yeah.
All right,
now. Oh, here you go. This is a little rough outline of it, man. Reader listener email now. Our first reader listener email, it go like this. A bitch from Los Angeles writes to BOSSMACK. She say, BOSSMACK, I'm a young grown ass woman out here trying to make it. I fuck with your show. And here is my question. My baby daddy is locked up for flocking. This nigga was doing great for a year or so, but this nigga spent all his money on jeans, a blown out flooded Rolex, and a Maserati with a fucked up transmission that we can't afford to fix.
She really wrote this?
This is real.
Oh, shit.
When a nigga was locked up, I couldn't get this nigga to stack paper or invest in any type of legitimate business. Now, when this nigga gets out, he's gonna go back to broke and back out there flocking. But when he up, he gonna turn into the same nigga. BOSSMACK, a bitch is tired. Keep it 100. To keep it 100, I got my little work boyfriend hooking me up on the low. BOSSMACK, any advice for a bitch trying to be loyal to a nigga that won't or can't change?
And where's she from? She from LA?
Real bitch.
And she asking this shit?
I feel like many bitches face this. This is a problem many bitches, all because all the niggas is flocking.
Man.
Niggas is doing criminal shit or some type of fashion, and I don't know. You know how it is. It's you don't want to be with no square nigga. See, that's the problem. See, bitch don't want to be with no square ass nigga that go to, you know, this 9 to 5 safe.
Oh,
don't talk
man.
Shit. Dress corny, you know what I'm saying? You don't want that nigga.
But see, that's what comes with what they want.
You want the fly nigga.
They want the fly nigga, the nigga getting to the bag.
Yeah.
You dig what I'm saying? But what they don't realize is much more than just getting to the bag.
Man.
You got to see the nigga whole procedure. If he's, what is he getting to the bag for?
Yeah.
Is he actually doing some shit with him? Females just be so mind boggled by, oh shit, bitch, he getting to it.
Yeah.
They're not even setting up for long term or long run, you feel me?
Yeah.
And like a square nigga, like, I'm gonna be real. I'd rather be a square than a nigga within a circle.
Man.
Cause a square is sharp on all four ends.
Okay.
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 Okay. And a circle got plenty of niggas that do the same shit.
But you say that from a perspective of kind of like a fly nigga. Though.
I say
like
that from a perspective of, like, of being in within a circle and being my own square.
Okay.
And being my own square allowed me to, all the fly niggas that's within a circle, they step out their element and start doing their own shit because they recognize their own flyness.
Right.
You dig what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
So it's like you got to be able to elevate outside of what's said or what's known to people.
Yeah.
We're oblivious to what's really going on out here. You know what I'm saying? People rather be within something that's popping rather to be in their own lane and gain.
Yeah.
You dig what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
I'd rather be in my own lane and gain than to be involved in something that's already popping. Everybody want to be involved in something that's popping. But when you're in your own lane, you gaining. You're gaining respect. You're gaining exposure. And you're gaining more people that want to do the shit you're doing now.
Yeah.
You dig me? So females be looking to that. Stop fucking with these inner circle niggas and go get you a square. You dig what I'm talking about? You understand where the real game and macking come from. You dig what I'm talking about?
Hey, man, you know what? Like, I always say, though, man, a lot of bitches, like, because, you know, I always was a working motherfucker, you know, slash hustle type nigga. You feel me? You know? You know, I done had a lot of bitches get took by tycoons, come down and take a bitch from me, man. I just had to accept it. You feel me?
Right.
And then it, you know, I understand what it is, the fast life. It's a lot of times a bitch got to go through it once or twice. You feel
once
me?
Once or twice in their life.
And then they be like, hold up, man, this shit ain't even fly right here. And maybe this her one time up. You know.
It's probably her.
Go through
she's
it.
She's at her baby daddy, right?
Yeah.
She gonna be back with the nigga. He, first of all, he's involved with her for life. She one of them, she sound like one of them baby mamas. She go have a good nigga right there by her side.
But still,
and she
gonna
still fuck it up and go to her baby daddy because she want her baby daddy to have the intentions of that good nigga. But she's already she just so stuck on her baby daddy. Now she need to wise up.
Yeah.
If she was any type of a smart female, she would have led by example. Like a female supposed to be a nigga backbone. So if you see he's getting all this money, any female that's with me and she see I'm getting a lot of money and I'm spending on dumb shit, I swear to God, she better start asking for money just so she can put it up secretly.
Yeah.
Do something smart. Yeah. Cause you complain about him not investing, but think about this. Bitch, you didn't invest either.
Yeah.
You was probably sitting there spinning the shit right with him while he's buying all these jeans and shit as she mentioned in the email.
Yeah.
Bitch, you talking about the transmission on the Maserati was fucked up, but I guarantee you was pulling up in it. You dig what I'm talking about? But bitch, where was you? You should have had a secret stash in that Maserati. You should have had some jeans in your closet that have nothing but knots in it, folded up in the midst of all them other jeans. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Females don't think. They think to complain, but they don't think to make a solution to their complaining. You dig me?
I think they just be enjoying the flyness while it's happening.
And then they want to complain when it's no more happening and the shit is down to rock bottom. Bitch, that's your job. I'm being a provider, bitch. You know what you do with leftover food? You store it. You put it up. You dig me?
Yeah.
You dig what I'm talking about? That's what they do. They clean the kitchen. They put up the food. I bring this food here for you to cook. Bitch, I ain't about to sit here, season this meat, cook this meat after I went out and worked for this meat. You go cook that dinner. Then when you're done with that food, you go put it up in store to make sure it stay fresh so we can eat it again, freeze it.
Yeah.
You dig what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
So it's the same with the money. Same with the money, bitch. We making all this money. Go get some of this money, bitch. Put this shit up. My job is to make the money and enjoy it.
Yeah.
I get the food and I enjoy it when you cook it. So the same way I'm getting this money, now listen, go put some of this shit up.
Yeah.
But I'm going to still enjoy it.
Yeah.
But be smart, be my backbone. Like, yeah. That's why I believe that's another reason I'm single too, man. Fuck, I can't deal with that fuck shit right there. Like, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Niggas know what they do to get their bro. So don't you want a female to put some, okay, baby, I got our jail account set up. If anything ever happened right now, we had this amount of money.
Yeah.
I want some shit like that. You feel me?
Yeah.
Oh, if this business don't have, I got this backup plan money. We got investing money put up. Cool.
Yeah.
You got this much spending money. Oh, shit. I want my bitch to be my accountant, nigga.
That's real.
You know what I'm talking about? Yeah. Like, females are so responsible with money. I swear to God. They have, like, $30,000, and then you think they really need your help. You feel me? A female have $30,000. And make you think she needs your help. On God. Females is the world's greatest finessers on everything I love. And if more females are inclined with their grind, they understand. Like, that's power females hold. But for a nigga to trust a female with his money,
All bitches ain't like that.
That's
it
why
it sound like that.
It's very few. It's a diamond in the rough.
But you right about that. It is bitches like that. I know a few, but then I know some dumb bitches, bro.
That's a lot of dumb bitches.
Strong.
And listen, we in today's society, no matter how much game you kick,
yeah,
they're not going to comprehend this shit.
Man, but we put it out there anyway.
We put it out there.
Because this conversation is going to last forever as long as it's YouTube and iTunes and shit.
I got some of my viewers, like, I'm not supposed to know some of the stuff I'm saying.
Hey, man.
I know it because experience.
Hey, man.
I've been at levels of this shit.
Hey, this is going to be out there for all posterity, I have you. But it's prosper, but posterity.
Posterity?
Yeah, that's like.
Posterity. Oh, okay.
As it extends in the time.
Oh, now you just gave me a new word for my freestyle.
It's like, you know, get money and shit. You feel me?
The way she stared at me is looking like she in posterity. Oh! God damn.
You verified. Look at the dictionary and make sure you get use it right.
Oh, yeah. You know I'm going to do that. Yeah. I'm going to do that
make
for sure.
I ain't tripping.
I'm going to do that
you
for know, sure.
I could be wrong and up here high and shit. You feel me? Like, think I'm talking right and shit. Okay, we got one more email.
Wait, hold on. We got a bitch from Los Angeles. Now, this next one is from Milwaukee.
Milwaukee. Here we go. A bitch from Milwaukee.
A bitch from Milwaukee.
A bitch from Milwaukee writes to Boss Mac. She says, Boss Mac, I'm a real ass bitch out here taking care of myself and paying bills. I'm single and I got a few fuck buddies and a few niggas I let kick it with me and smoke on some friendship. This one older nigga that I let come through and smoke with me that I thought was my friend flipped out on a bitch the other night. We was smoking and all of a sudden the nigga gets to talking about how much he loves me and I jacks off to my Instagram pics and shit. I mean, some complete weirdo shit. I had to end the night on that nigga. Now my question is this. I kept it 100 with that nigga from the gate. I told him we could kick it on some friendship. He say, cool. Now what the fuck? Explain how to be 100 with niggas.
That's some shit. Hey, can I speak up on this for that bitch?
Flow and glow.
She should have known. First of all, you admitted already. She gave the open invite when she let us know she got niggas she let come over and smoke and chill. She got a few fuck buddies.
Right.
Now, you're not oblivious to the fact of what goes on around you. And if it's an OG nigga, he's sure not oblivious to the fact of what's going on. Okay, a little hottie, okay. Shit, niggas kick it and chill. I'm gonna try my move. But he was actually probably really digging her.
Yeah.
That shit came fast.
I. Yeah, man. I feel like. I feel like, you know what I'm saying? Bitches know what they doing.
You know,
bitches be pimping too. They put together their stables and shit.
They got a little formula.
Niggas. It don't matter what you say to a nigga. A nigga is there to fuck. You know what I'm saying? If you got him on some tricking shit, like to come through with the weed and shit, eventually a nigga want to fuck. I mean, a nigga got to put in his beard at some time. You just got to hope a nigga don't just take some pussy with that shit you doing. You feel me? Get in there dangling the pussy in front of a nigga high. You know what I'm saying? Next thing you nigga just be like, fuck this bullshit.
Yeah, but then again, he was kind of weirdo shit about, I ain't gonna jack off to no bitch Instagram.
See, and then
that part right there, he said a red flag. You dig me? So that makes me think, what if bro was in there taking pictures of her just walking around, or taking videos of her just walking around them chilling and smoking? Like, that is some weirdo shit. That's weirdo right there.
Yeah, man.
You dig what I'm talking about?
Yeah, like.
I don't know. He ain't never fucked. I don't think he ever fucked. How she was describing it.
I mean, she just clearly was like, she had niggas for certain jobs and shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, bitches.
It was probably her weed and drink provider.
Bitches put together teams like that on niggas. They put together, you know, these niggas, I fucked these three niggas. And then this other nigga, you know, he can't fuck, but he's cool.
Hey, I like his company.
Yeah.
And he listens to me.
Yeah, he listen to me talk about
he give
my
me
whole
advice
day.
On how to handle these other niggas. Yeah, man. Females' game is tight as fuck, and niggas got to pay attention to that shit. You could be sitting there giving a bitch some game, thinking you looking out for her and being cool, just conversing with her, but you're giving her a game on how to handle a whole nother nigga or two. You dig me?
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Here you go.
That shit hit there, huh? That's
all right, so there's a couple of emails just to get them out. You know, I want to come back and close it out on a couple of things with you. I don't want this. Now... I observed the war that's happening right now. I mean, it's still, to me, it seemed like it's still happening subtly, because the RJ Greedo thing.
Right.
I noticed how y'all orchestrated that into money. I was really impressed by that shit, man. How was you instrumental in bringing that together? If you could speak on it any type of way.
Honestly speaking, shout out to Tay F3rd, the unicorn of Long Beach.
Okay.
He on live right now watching. That's one of the big boys artists.
You know he been on the fucking show before. You know that, right?
Tayas?
Yeah.
That's my dog. He better have you invited him. He better have Kane.
Yeah.
I just got news that Cockbitch Cree got on what's her name? She got on Cardi B about that shit we were just talking about.
I have to bring that back up to you, bro. Okay. Yeah, that's what I was gonna say, man. Like, we ain't addressed that properly. Yeah,
that's crazy.
We ain't addressed that properly.
That's how you know people tuned in to us.
I wasn't gonna let you leave up out of here. That's why I brought this shit back. Uh-huh. Because you went into a different direction, and I let you go.
Yeah.
Because you was explaining your shit. But okay, now.
What up, Riot? But what was the question you just asked? Oh, how was our instrument in that?
In that.
Basically, how it happened.
Cause I seen it.
I woke up and seen the beef.
Right.
And I got on Instagram how I always do every morning.
Right.
Talking my shit on Instagram and everything. Boom. And I was talking to myself like, damn, why is the bros going at it, whatever, whoop de whoop. You know what? Then I started thinking to myself out loud though, but I'm on live. You know, I'm not thinking nothing much of it.
Right.
I'm like, oh shit, I could throw the biggest summer event. That's how I thought about it. I can throw the biggest summer event. RJ versus Greedo, whoop do whoop. Oh God. I'm sitting like, yeah. I was like, wait, summer too far, so I can do like a spring bling. Yeah. You know, I'm thinking, because I'm thinking to myself, I got to collect, get the money together. Everything nowadays is about money.
Right.
I should have kept that shit written down.
Right.
But God works in mysterious ways. It's the reason why everything happens. Said it out loud, nigga. Not even a few hours later. Okay, I'm lying. I'm over exaggerating. A few hours later. Like a day later, I get a call. Oh, you know what's it's a RJ versus Greedo. They already booked that, whatever. Wait, what?
Oh, you just, how? You just thought of it and niggas mm-hmm. already, some other niggas acting.
So I'm like, ow. I'm kind of finding out. This is how you know it's nothing but God. How is it the person who booked it is the person who booked me to host the shows at their events, the Observatory and the Novo?
Right.
I'm like, oh, this is home base. But that's ironic, right?
But so he was watching it unfold and just jumped on it.
Watching it, oh, Pookie got an idea. Boom, let's make it happen. So, I felt like, hold up. If they gonna do anything off an idea I thought of and everybody know I thought of this idea, I need to be involved.
Right.
So I got in motion. I put a post on it and said, everybody tag Observatory and tell them I should host this. Boom! Went crazy. Everybody tagging Observatory. Hey, yo, this is a Pookie idea. Y'all so stole Pookie idea.
You just forced your involvement.
I fucking pushed my way in the door. I told you. I don't sell out for shit, but I will make my ends
and how I want to do my shit, you feel me? Okay.
So, boom. Out of respect, I love the Observatory. I love the Novo. You dig me? This didn't do shit, but brought me closer and brought me to the people I needed to be close to.
Right.
I was always doing middleman shit. I was always getting instructions from a middleman. I was always middlemaning, hearing this, hearing that, and other. The Observatory been fucking with me for about 2 years.
Yeah.
Allowing me to host events, book people, all that. So now, we did this event in Orange County.
Right.
It was a success. No problems, no nothing.
Right.
Boom. Okay. They so damn happy at how shit was handled. Did it again at the Novo. Boom. This time at the Novo, after we do that, I get a call from the main dude who put it on. Shout out to Golden Voice Entertainment. You feel me? My boy Dom.
Yeah.
I'm actually undergoing a name change right now. People know me as Pookie F'n Rude. You dig me? The king of turn up is always going to stay.
Right.
But for me doing my job, I brought two gangs from different sides together two times within... Right. Within less than a month time frame, within 2 weeks apart from each other. You get what I'm saying? No problems at either one. It brought unity to people.
Right.
It showed people that LA could do shit. We could do good events, big events, good shit within our own artists and self with no problems and come together and have fun.
Okay.
You dig what I'm saying? Set a bar out there.
Okay, now, hold up. Now I'm going to ask you to keep it 100.
Oh.
I was watching the footage.
Yeah, this question is going to be a question that many people ask me. Who won? I was about to ask, who won?
I mean, could you really even... Because you know what? At first, I thought it was looking kind of rough for RJ.
Mm-mm. Let me help you understand.
But let me finish.
Go ahead.
But then I seen different footage. And it was like lit all the way. To me, it was like a uniform lit. I mean, you know.
This is what it is. We went song for song.
Right.
You dig me?
Right.
I think that was the best way.
Right.
And once again.
You introduced that they should do
yeah,
it like
yeah.
that.
I did the introduction. Everything set you know, the rules and all that.
I seen Tory Lanez and what's his name do that shit.
For the Drake?
Tory Lanez and. ASAP Ferg did that at Observatory.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was tight. I thought you had got it from that, but go ahead.
So I brought them both out. Yeah. And it's like, this is where it becomes mind-boggling. Everybody's looking at, oh, who had the crowd turned up the most or this and that, whoa.
Right.
That's cool. That's cool to observe, but you got to think about this. Stage presence. Good sportsmanship.
Right.
Marketing strategies.
Right.
Okay. This is like, this was a competition like you put Kobe Bryant against Lorenz Ball.
Right.
You know what I'm talking about?
Right.
That's his name, Lonzo Ball.
Lonzo Ball.
Lonzo. Lonzo Ball. Y'all know who the fuck I'm talking about. Lonzo. That's like you putting Kobe Bryant against Lonzo Ball.
Yeah, you gotta say his name right because you might end up fucking with him.
Oh, that's cool. They understand it's a mistake. Lonzo, my bad, brother. Yeah. Okay. But you know, but you get where I'm going with this. Lonzo Ball is a great player. He's good.
Right.
But he has experience to still gain.
Right.
Versus Kobe Bryant been doing this shit in the game.
Right.
Gained experience.
Right.
You know what I'm talking about? So it's like now you got RJ versus Greedo. Greedo got fucking talent.
Right.
But his experience is not as up there as yours, RJ.
Right.
Greedo has hits, but his collection of songs is not up there as yours.
Right. RJ.
No, but listen, RJ has phenomenal stage fucking presence.
Right.
So this was a smart event.
Right.
Now, Greedo is able to observe and he could learn.
Right.
And RJ can observe and he could learn.
Right.
They both could feed off each other. The energy was fucking great.
Right.
I never seen RJ perform at such a great level. RJ brought comedy.
It pushed
RJ to a limit to like, you know what, I'm gonna show you what the fuck I could do.
RJ stepped
out of his element of just straight. RJ comes out and killed any show.
Right.
But he stepped out of his anime. I never seen RJ really do comedy like that. And he did some comedy at the show. Like, and that had me like, damn, this is dope. They're putting on a show for the people. Look at this. He came out with a wig and everything. I'm like, this is dope as fuck. And you have to actually be creative to think of shit like that. They're both being creative. Greedo is a creative individual automatically.
Right.
You feel what I'm talking about?
Right.
So, but what Greedo did, he did a marketing strategy.
Yeah.
He performed songs that niggas did not know at all.
Right.
His first 2 to 3 songs.
Right.
But it made niggas wonder after the show, what was those songs he performed?
Right.
Fucking great marketing strategy.
Right.
Then he performed hits that you knew.
Right.
You dig what I'm talking about?
Right.
They both came out there. It's like two heavy hitters, bro.
Right.
So I don't have a winner, nigga. I say we won as LA.
Right.
LA won as a collective.
Right.
Period. The streets won as coming together and unifying.
Right. Now both shows was uniform.
Man,
in the same
both.
Energy.
Yes. And the LA one was more so like, damn. Greedo brought out all the projects, literally. He brought out, the whole projects came out supported, and that was so much love. Like, look at this. They coming out, and they're being respectful.
Right.
I tip my hat to the Anthems. I tip my hat to the Gray Street Watts.
Right.
I tip my hat to every other gang that was in there in the midst.
Right.
Everybody handled themselves in an accordingly way.
And
that just makes me happy. Like, fuck, y'all just gave me a good image. And my image is what they look at, like LA and the artists that come, the urban artists. Yeah. They don't, the black artists that come from the underground.
Yeah.
They don't know how to control themselves. That's what they look at us as. Yeah. It's hard for me to get people to do shows. People don't understand. It's hard for me to get my job done. And they think it's so easy. Pookie, book me for that. Book me for that. I don't ignore niggas at all, but it's just hard for me to get a lot of niggas in the club to do they shit if they don't have a great name for themselves because clubs are weary of that.
Yeah.
But we just showed them we could do it.
Right, you did.
We just showed them. We used two artists from LA.
Yeah.
No other greater, bigger artists.
Motherfuckers.
Come on, man. Two artists. You can't forget about when Joe Moses and Nipsey did it, too. They did the Observatory. But that's Santa Ana.
Right.
I did Santa Ana and LA.
Yeah.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
But it's been going on. The unifying been happening. So we got to keep it going.
Yeah.
And it's like, we make more money doing that.
Yeah.
You feel me?
Okay, I have a critique of what I thought. Observing. The only thing I did not like is it was too many niggas on stage.
That's everybody's complaint.
Because you want to see the niggas. Like, the only thing I didn't like about the first RJ show was niggas came out with all red on, and he had on red too, so it's hard to know who he was. So I wish he would have dressed different. Like, he would have had on white, and then on red. You feel me?
Right.
And then it was too many niggas on stage. Like, it was just, I want to see him. Like, you feel me?
Right.
And then I want to see y'all. I want to see you and Greedo. I want to see y'all do y'all move around.
But see,
shit.
And that right there.
You know what I'm saying?
They were saying I was cheating when I was hyping up Greedo's set. So I had to respect.
You doing your job, bro.
Exactly. But at this precise time, I had to be neutral. Like, I'm neutral, period. But at this precise time, I had to fall back. And yeah. But I can't help it. Run For My Life and Rude, those are two songs I'm going to automatically turn up on. Can't nobody tell me nothing. Those are my songs. Those are the songs that I feel. Run For Your Life. I rode through the projects in a school bus playing Run For Your Life. That's my shit. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah. Okay, now.
Yeah.
All right, now. I want to shift gears a little bit and bring it now. The Cardi B shit, right? Now, I didn't even know that shit had happened until, like, I saw one of the homies had some shit on there, like, motherfuckers better not start dissing Pi Rue or some shit. I didn't understand what he meant by that. He was like...
Well, I guess because... Don't Cardi B be claiming like...
No, wait. Because let me tell you how I came to
it. Go ahead.
Okay. He was like, Cardi B said what she said, but motherfuckers better not start dissing Pi Rue. Right. You know. So then I seen Cop Pistol Creed video. You seen that?
I haven't seen it yet, man, but I'm going to check it out when we leave here.
Man. And see, that's I wanted to talk to you about that because, like, Cardi B came with the I hate wearing flu or some shit like that. I think she put that. Okay. You didn't. Now, they cripping in New York, too.
I know.
You know what I'm saying?
It's,
so
it's a lot of babies
we didn't
in New
hear
York.
Nothing from New York. We didn't hear nobody was upset Brooklyn. About that. You know. Bobby Smurda and them was Crips. You feel me?
Oh, I know.
They killers, too, supposedly.
Oh, I know. Not supposedly.
Okay, nobody said. Well, maybe they
them
did.
Niggas all
maybe
over
they
there,
did.
They really with the shits.
Maybe they did. But the most noise came from Cock Pistol Creed, though. You feel me?
Yeah, I got people saying Cock Pistol Creed had more balls than the niggas.
Listen, my nigga. On Glasses Malone page, a nigga posted a nigga. And then a couple of bitches, too. Instagram took it off her page.
Over whose?
Off a Cock Pistol Creed page, I heard.
Did anybody got the video?
It's on...
I need to see the video.
I think it's on Big Sade page. I don't know if you follow her.
Damn. They said she... Did she say... I hope
it's
she
on Glasses Malone page, too, though.
She didn't say nothing about the Pyros, did she?
But she said niggas gonna start. She said y'all better check that bitch. She said some shit, man. Listen,
you got bring it up, man. I want to see that shit, man.
Listen, man. Cock Pistol Creed, hey man. Listen,
she got her name back up there, boy.
She came so hard. She came. Hey, listen, man. That's why I wanted you to speak on that shit because.
She just told them to stay out of it. Okay. Hey, Cock Pistol Creed, I got my debut scene with her. I'm giving her head in the car on her Lady Killer video.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, that's me.
That's you?
That's me.
That's some classic shit, man. That is. I don't, man, I was just, this is it right here. This is what she said.
I love Cock Pistol Creed.
Cock Pistol Creed. Hey, man. Hey. Cardi B, like, really? I fuck with Cardi B, bro. I fuck with her. I fuck with Cardi B. But I feel like she gotta respond to that.
Weirdo? Oh, cock Mr. Cree. That, see that shit right there? That shit just made me horny, nigga. God damn, that just made a nigga horny. Like, oh, she hit him with the weirdo. Come here. Come here. Checking that bitch like that. Yeah, come here.
That was beautiful.
That's a strong black queen right there. And she spoke with the utmost respect. She didn't even disrespect her or nothing.
Hey, man.
Oh, cock pistol. Listen, man, girl. Come way here. In New Somebody York. Tag cock pistol queen. Record this shit and tell her what the fuck I said.
She way in New York disrespecting crap.
Look at cock pistol. I'm glad I'm in the video giving her head, cuz.
Hey, man. Hey,
I didn't even see. I just heard about the Cardi B shit today. Like, y'all know I don't be on the internet looking at shit like that, man.
Some real LA bitches is really hot. And I'm telling you, listen, I'm finna listen, my nigga. I'm gonna keep it 100 with you. You know, the powers that be.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the powers that be over there in great, nigga, put a call in on that, bro. You feel me?
Yeah.
This niggas put a call in. Was like, bitch, gotta apologize.
Is she gonna apologize?
I don't know.
It's seeming like Cardi B want to keep going on with the shit, like. Did she respond or anything?
She deleted this shit.
Cardi B did?
She changed the whole, like... Yeah. She changed the whole... You feel me?
Yeah.
She changed the whole shit. But, you know, a lot of people was, like, really upset, man. So.
She blocked their comments. That's crazy.
She gotta apologize.
She has to. Cocky Pistol Cree said some real shit though. See, I didn't even see the Cardi B shit. I just heard about it. Man, I need to start paying more attention to this internet shit. She said all you internet ass Crips ain't doing shit. Damn. She said some real shit though. It took for her to say something.
Yeah, my nigga, it's like, you know, it's bad, man. I think that's why I was asking you, man. Like, I was wondering if you's like, because I feel like some bitches would have said something to you about it. You feel me? Like, because it's like really bad. You feel me?
Right.
Yeah. But I feel like she's going to come out and apologize, though.
You think so?
But here's the thing about that. I feel like if she apologized, that make her look bad.
No. It make her look like she noticed the mistake she made. Be a bigger person and grow from it and move on. I don't get what people think doing the right thing is looking bad for.
Okay, but if you tough, though.
Fucking tough. Even a tough nigga. My fault, nigga. Period.
I mean, my bad, nigga. But that's
you don't have to be all sympathetic. I'm sorry. My fault. You know what I'm saying? Wasn't, you know, no disrespect to that extent. My bad. Period. You got to understand at the end of the day, bitch, you're not from California. So you really don't have no type of understanding of what you're saying. That touched people in like a different way.
Do you realize, like, hoods that's not even cool with each other unify over shit?
I'm out here unifying shit with niggas in the same state, and this bitch out of state want to start doing some dividing shit.
Nah, but that I mean, you know, that'll unify some. Nah, I'm talking about like on the crimp car, like that got everybody upset together.
But see, she did some unifying on one side, but she's still trying to make it divided. Fuck that! I'm trying to unify everybody.
I feel you.
You feel me?
But I feel like niggas out here is like, I feel like the vibe from niggas out here, like, I mean, I don't know for sure, but I feel like the vibe of like the real Pyru niggas from out here is like,
they kind of even feel like
it's sympathetic. Not even sympathetic.
They feel like, goddamn, that's disrespectful. We don't even go that far.
You feel me?
You know what I'm saying?
It's like everybody sitting back going, bitch, wait a minute, you're out of line. That's what it's like. It's like everybody sit back and go, hold on, bitch.
Wait
a minute. We've been giving you a pass, though. It's like everybody remember, like, wait a minute, bitch. We've just been.
Changing your name to Barty B. Like,
we really
hold on,
just
bitch.
Been letting you do that. Like, we. You feel me?
Hold on, bitch. What you doing? Yeah, I'm not. What time is it?
Yeah, man. We got to wrap it up, man. We pushed it. 12 o'clock, man.
Damn.
We almost 2 hours in, man. You know what I'm saying? I just wanted to address that Cardi shit a little bit more.
Nigga.
I tried to cover everything on you.
You got a real good exclusive interview.
I think, you know what I'm saying? You think so?
Yeah, I let you know some shit that people don't know.
How was your live? Was your live popping?
My live's still going up. It's still going up right now. People actually tuned in to what the fuck we talking about.
Damn, man. That's cool, man. I appreciate that. Well, how do my people get at you, man, on the ground, man?
Ah, man, if you want to find me, you know, you don't have to do that much of typing or searching. You just put in King of Turnup.
Mm-hmm.
Add another P after that P that you put in turn up, and you're going to see my name pop right up.
Mm-hmm.
King of Turn Up, Pookie F'n Rude. Yeah, no. Like I said, I'm going under a name change. It'll be King of Turn Up, Pookie the Great. No more Pookie F'n Rude. I got to step into another element. It's called money.
It's going to be Pookie the Great.
Pookie the Great. And I got that name from actually the dude that runs the Novo and Observatory.
He said, man, you got to change your name to Pookie the Great.
He changed my name to Pookie the Great. And I'm the type of nigga, okay, if you just want me to change my name and that still matches me and it's going to cause me to get booked on more areas, let's do it. Let's take out the fucking Rude and put in the Great. I'll do that any day.
That nigga,
because that's still me. You dig me?
I'm changing my name to Pookie the Great.
Pookie the Great.
That's pretty dope, man. Who thought of that?
His name is Dom.
That's kind of cool, man.
Yeah, Pookie the Great. And it's crazy because when I walked in his office, right when I walked out the elevator, his secretary's like, so you're Pookie the Great? I said, wow, shit. Pookie the Great.
Sounds good, huh?
Damn, Pookie the fucking Great.
I feel you,
man. I finally went to the office and shook the nigga hand. It's no more third party shit.
Uh-huh.
Like, the nigga that signs the checks for shit.
Yeah.
Say your name is Pookie the Great. If y'all look at the LA tickets, that's all they say it on there. Pookie the Great presents.
Yeah.
RJ versus Greedo. What the fuck I present? Okay. What the fuck?
Okay.
So you know, I just want to say everybody keep supporting. I fuck with you. I support this Boss Mac.
I appreciate it, bro.
I'm gonna help you get some people come in. Interviews for your podcast. I fuck with it. It's dope.
I appreciate it, my nigga. Yeah.
Keep going.
Yeah,
this ain't the last you're gonna be seeing or fucking with me, man.
Yeah, man, I'm gonna bring it back. You know, as time passed, shit happened. Come back in, get shit off your chest. You might want to let some shit out and let motherfuckers know some shit.
Just come here and freely be like bitches.
Yeah, man, this happened and that happened and fuck them and I'm doing this now and this happened. Nigga.
That part.
You feel me? But like I said, man, I seen you out there doing your thing. I fuck with people to be trying to make shit happen. You know what I'm saying? That's why I just keep it real, man. I just really, like I said, I've been keeping my eye on my nigga Greedo for many years. I don't even know him.
Right, that's my dog.
But, you know, he was in, you know, I'm from Campanella Park over there. And,
mm-hmm.
and he was over there with some of my little homies. And he was...
This whole time you've been from Campanella Park?
Yeah.
That's dope. That's dope as fuck.
Yeah.
That's dope.
Is that cool? Is that
what? That's all love.
Vanilla.
I don't see no color. I fuck with y'all too.
Yeah, that's my people.
Come on, man.
So like I would have had my guy here, man, but I don't have three microphones. My microphone tripping. I would have had my other guy here. He from the hood too. But anyway, like I said, Greedo was. I knew him as Greedy Giddy.
Exactly, Greedy Giddy.
And I actually, you know, keep it 100, man. I was trying to get him on the podcast. And I thought I might have had disrespected him because I called him Greedy Giddy when I talked to him on the phone. I was like, Greedy Giddy, what's up, nigga?
When he hear people say that, that's how he know people been knowing him.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, he don't get mad at that. Like,
oh, okay. I didn't want a nigga to think like I don't want to acknowledge the change. You feel me? Because some niggas be like, I'm a new nigga now. You feel me? Like, but anyway, I've been watching. He did a song with my homie, my little homie. Young Ed.
Right.
And that was a song Ed rocked, like some of my gear in the video. I hooked him up with a snapback and some other shit. Like I said, I was keeping my eye on the niggas, man. And that song, man, I was telling the homie, I was like, yo, man, you need to keep fucking with this nigga right here, man. The other niggas, man, is whack, man. I'm telling you, man, this nigga right here. I don't know what happened, but I always kept my eye on Greedo, man. So that's why when I seen y'all doing shit, man, that's why I was like, yo. And I noticed, I seen the transition from when he was doing shows by himself and then when you started being his hype, man. And that's what made me think that you was like a hype man for hire, if need be, like, if you know what I mean? Because your talent, you know, I really, like, I don't look at that job as like a low job. That's like a hard job. That's like a for real position.
Oh, everything.
And the great motherfuckers to do it really stand out. There's a couple motherfuckers out there in the world to do that shit from that perspective, man. And niggas is hella tight.
You know. I love it. Yeah. It's me interacting with the people, being able to vibe out with them, you know.
But let me close this shit out. We done, man. 2 hours and shit, man. I appreciate you coming out, man. I'm gonna mix this shit down. It's gonna be lit. God bless.
All right.
Yeah. Alright. Yeah, man.
Gentlemen, thank you for coming out. The Top Mac Nigga Show is a BOSSMACK Industries production. Put your hands together for a special musical guest. I ain't gonna even say no names.
Yeah, this is also off of my mixtape, and this is me and Young T.O. one more time going back and forth, kind of like, what was that one song? T Grizzly and Lil Yachty, D to the A. So, I'm gonna holler at y'all. We'll wrap it up, but let them hear this hot shit.
Oh, three. All right, jump a gang in, it's time to make it burn. Chopper, I don't need no iron. That's OBRB in this bitch. Young T.O. and OB in this shit. Gucci Bentley loafers, tough with big blue faces. I'ma keep it brief like the Gucci suitcases. Crippin', but I stay away from chubby shoelaces. Hit his ass once, but he bled in two places. Rosé, everything, got expensive taste, bitch. How you clean your eyes, bitch? I use toothpaste. It's a baby face, baby low, baby sitting paper. Child support, yeah, right, my BM getting paid.
Young nigga got rich and I ain't looked back since. I got diamonds in my mouth, I got clips on clips. I got sauce in my drip, I got straps like tips. I got shooters on call, them niggas shoot, don't miss. I got times I quit, but them times ain't shit. Sit your niggas on the skid, don't get respect for assist. I got times when I'm coming, most times my trick. All these niggas wanna ride, I ain't providing a lift.
Buy my bitch a purse, boy, my daughter and my shooter. It's 10,000 for a verse, or a show if you a loser. Yeah, maybe you was real, but a pussy introduces. If I feel that you was real, I might just do it off the stripper. Nigga, boss man, ice man, buzzy. She creep up like a wolf, I make a holly sign, she bust it. Goddamn, we just friends, fuck it. That pussy got me hooked, so I might make it be my one.
Got some niggas that I slide at, D-dub in this bitch. Love to get you killed, and you loving that bitch. If I had to make a choice, I'd make a nigga strip. I need money, every dollar, every chain in this bitch.
bitch. Nigga, fuck fame, all my niggas get paid. And these niggas don't want smoke, all these niggas getting saved. Niggas talk crazy when I ain't typing on that page. I got demons in real life, but niggas thinking that they pray.
Any side of California, people know I'm very loyal. Trap game made me royal, rap game made me spoil. She doing my dreads butt naked with Jamaican oils. I'm eating Jamaican food and bumping Rudes early morning. Hella horny, I can't fuck a bitch if her little body bony. She say, boy, you sleeping, I'ma teach you that she acting phony. Goddamn, she get it in, I'ma fuck everybody. I be out here shitting on these niggas like a porta potty.
All these diamonds on my neck, I'm the main attraction. I'm that nigga setting plays like I'm Phil Jackson. Sending shots without no guns, that's a little backwards. Suckin' suffering financially, niggas Twitter trapping. And you would get your ass smoked with all that Twitter yapping. I mean, like, way less talking, more interaction. Got some niggas I can't trust that I'm still attached with. Know some niggas who be acting, but they really actress.
Jordan down, Project Barney turned into a private party. Had to spend the night with Shardy, woke up eating calamari. Been a cop of white Ferrari, smash up on the cops, I'm sorry. Blow a bacon, cop a Gari. iPhone X forgot the charger. Genius, but I'm out for Target. Walking with the Mega Target, bitch, I push a hard bargain. Blowing on Nintendo cart, you racks my bitch on Dolly Parton. Big titties, knockers at the door, you plugging, end up on that milk carton, bitch.
All my niggas really demons, get the shoe for no reason. Catch a sucker trying to slide and have him stand where ain't leaving. And I'm going against the odds, but all my $100 even. All my niggas with the beef and all you niggas turning vegan. I don't even want your bitch, still a taker for the weekend. I got money on my mind, I know exactly what you thinking. I know temptation efficiency, a dumb bitch that sent me. I got triggers on these semis, squeeze it 50 till it's empty. Bitch,